Joining us now from the Maryland SPCA is Katie Flory with some very important information to help you get your pet prepared in the event of an emergency. And Katie, of course, you have also brought one of your adorable animals. This is Bella, and she's very active.
She is. Bella is a one-year-old Jack Russell miniature pincher mix. She's a year old, full of energy. Mm-hmm. She would do great for a family who is very active.
She loves
to give kisses. Mm-hmm. I think she also really enjoys cooking because she was watching the chef outside make his breakfast and looked like she very much enjoyed it. But she's also a love bug. She's a sweet girl and she needs a new home.
Oh, okay. Well, let's talk a little bit about emergency preparedness. I mean, we always think for our families, you know, water and a light kit and batteries and those kinds
Absolutely.
Of things. But sometimes we can forget about our four-legged friends.
We can, and we've had such a bad summer when it comes to disasters, and now we're getting into the winter. Mm-hmm. So we need to think about our pets. Have a go bag ready. Mm-hmm. Make sure that you're thinking about a first aid kit. We think about ourselves, but we don't always think about the animal. A very sturdy leather or nylon 6-foot leash. Mm-hmm. Also a carrier. A lot of people are getting the softer carriers. Make sure you have a hard carrier with your
sturdy.
Name and your telephone number on it.
Yeah.
Any medications that the pet might need. Most important thing, tags. Mm-hmm. Make sure the tags are current, up to date, and have a plan. Have it written out, have emergency numbers, and so you know if an emergency comes, what you need to do to make sure your pet's ready to go.
I was also told that it's important to kind of have that paperwork, and as far as, you know, what shots that the animal have
Absolutely.
That ready, because in the event that the animal needs to go to a shelter, they may not know or they may not take them
exactly.
in.
Exactly, and knowing. Make sure they're in a plastic bag, because oftentimes, especially with a hurricane or snow, they could get wet. Also have an up-to-date picture of your pet with distinguishing marks. So if for some reason the two of you get separated, people will know how to get you guys back together.
Mm-hmm. And food, water, of
food,
course.
Food, water. We think
set.
About it for us, but you want to make sure you have enough water for your pet, and we recommend 3 days worth of water.
All right, so if someone wants to adopt Bella, what
they
should they do?
Come to the shelter today. We are open from 11 to 4. They can also go to our website, which is www.mdspca.org. We have so many animals that are looking for good homes, so please come visit us.
All right, Katie, good meeting you. I will
you
see
too.
You again, and of course the Maryland SPCA, the phone number 410-235-8826. Thank you.